Hi, welcome back everyone. Back with another video, so a little bit different. I got back into the theory of two-stroke exhaust pipes, so I thought I'd like to show this. There's a wave viewer feature in EngMod 2T, which actually shows the pressure waves as they travel down an expansion pipe or any pipe. And I thought I'd show that, do some simulations with a straight pipe to show why that's not great on a two-stroke. Then modify it. Obviously not this pipe, but to simulate something like this where you just have a diffuser section. So you should still get that depression at bottom dead centre. And then finally, look at a full pipe and actually how that really, really works really well and show the performance differences, but also to look at the waves and hopefully explain how these waves work within an expansion pipe. And that's what actually gives us that extra power, that supercharging effect. Also, check out AU Mechanic. I've rewatched his videos, getting myself back into the theory. I'll leave a link in the description. He does a really good series of how pipes work. Two-stroke stuffing's got a good one as well, with some water in a bottle, which is actually really good if you want to visualise it. Hopefully, though, the wave viewer I'm going to show today should help people visualise what's going on inside these very simple but very effective pieces of metal.
Right, a bit of an explanation. It shows you basically the waves that are produced at any given point throughout the expansion pipe for a given piston position, and you'll see this piston move up and down. We're really interested in the area where the exhaust ports open and also the transfer ports are open. And we've got the pressure ratio down this axis. So one is atmospheric pressure, 0.5 and 0 is obviously below atmospheric pressure. And obviously above that is above atmospheric pressure. First of all, you have three waves. You have the superposition wave, and that is green. So in this case, I'm just gonna draw it there. But it's made up of two waves, a wave that goes right and a wave that goes left. So the rightward wave, if for example this wave here, which is going right, and then conversely a wave that had come back down the pipe would be the left. And again, these waves are just a snapshot in time. These left and right waves are added together and they make up the superposition wave. The superposition wave is what you would be able to measure with a pressure transducer. The actual left and right wave themselves are in theory theoretical, and they can only be calculated in simulation software such as EngMod 2T, which is what's happened here. However, these constantly move, and you'll see throughout the simulation, and we'll look at where we get our negative pressure or low pressure area, which helps draw on the exhaust port, draw on the transfers to help scavenge the cylinder and pull that fresh mixture in, and also get rid of the spent exhaust gases. But conversely, at the end of the cycle, you'll see where we get a higher pressure here, which is effectively pushing fresh charge back into the cylinder. Okay, a bit more about wave flow and direction. So obviously we've got our left and right waves there, expansive and compressive waves. So to start off with, we're just going to look at compressive waves. So these compressive waves are always greater than 1 atm. So you can have two types. You can have a rightward moving wave, so that's away from the piston towards the exhaust, and it looked like that. And you can have another one that goes leftward, and again like that. Now, in terms of direction of the wave direction, so the wave direction going to the right would induce a gas particle movement to the right, so the flow would be to the right, and conversely a wave that's moving to the left would also induce a leftward flow in the gas particles. So that's the compressive wave. and again they're always greater than one. However, conversely, less than one, as we saw before on here, that is known as an expansion wave. So, as I've already stated, that's below one. So, you can have a rightward moving expansion wave, would look like this, and a leftward expansion wave would look like that. So in terms of direction, so the wave is going that way, however the flow it induces into the gas particles is the opposite direction. So when we've got a leftward wave, we get a rightward flow. So that's a little overview of what you see in the wave viewer and what it all comes down to. And ultimately it's this green bit that we can actually measure. So if you actually instrument an exhaust, which I would actually like to do at some point, this is what we'll see. But bear in mind it's made up of the right and leftward wave. This is the blue screen shown when you're doing a simulation in Engmod 2T. So the green line is the instantaneous pressure at the exhaust port. The red line is the in-cylinder pressure. So as you can see through the blowdown phase with high peak amplitude here, which then reduces down when it goes below atmosphere, that's where it's sucking on the transfers, and then again it increases in value as you can see, greater than cylinder pressure, so forcing some of that mixture back into the cylinder. So for the sim, I used a file that came with Engmod 2T for a TZ250. It's putting out just under 45 horsepower. Note, this is for one cylinder. So now we'll have a look at the three different pipes and how the different shapes of the pipes affect the pressure waves within that. Right, first up, four stroke pipe. So pistons uncovered the exhaust port. You've got the right compression wave traveling down the pipe. There's no reflection, so there's no leftward moving wave until it gets to the end of the pipe. It then gets reflected back up as a left expansion wave. You can see the superposition pressure start to drop and match that leftward wave, as there's not a great deal of right compressive wave there. And as the piston gets down to bottom dead center, it's still above atmosphere. It's now just dropping down, and there is some below atmosphere pressure. So there is a lower pressure there. It should be helping to scavenge the cylinder. However, as the exhaust closes, as you can see, there's no higher pressure there to push some of the fresh mixtures back in. And we should see the results of that when we compare all the power graphs at the end. Next up, we've just got a diffuser section. So half an expansion pipe effectively. So let's see what happens. So we're going to get the blowdown, as we did before. So we've got a rightward moving compression wave that's traveling down, but immediately see this time the left moving wave, there is starting to be, it's starting to move below atmospheric pressure. And that is as the diffuser action starts to act as a open pipe, but not quite as abrupt as the previous pipe. And then when it gets to the end of that pipe, you can see the left moving expansion wave moving up, and it's pretty well timed for bottom dead center, so it'll be sucking out quite a bit of fresh mixture, helping scavenge the cylinder. But the problem we're going to have this time is, again, there is no return wave at high pressure to then reverse some of that mixture and help trap it in the cylinder for better trapping efficiency and more power. Okay, and thirdly, we've got the full expansion pipe this time. So blowdown, rightward moving compression wave travels down the pipe at the exhaust port, down the header, and continues down. You can immediately see there is a left hand expansion wave starting to generate a lower pressure at the exhaust port to help scavenge as the exhaust, as the piston descends to bottom dead center. But this rightward wave, compression wave, still going down, meets the baffle cone, gets reflected and you can start seeing that the left moving wave now becomes a compression wave and starts to move back down leftwards back to the exhaust port where it should be able to stuff some extra mixture in. So all the suction's done now, and we're now starting to build up pressure from the left moving wave, and you can see the superposition wave as well, and that is stuffing some of that fresh mixture back into the exhaust, increasing trapping efficiency, increasing power. And here you can see the results in the power graph. So red is your four stroke straight pipe, black is just the diffuser section, and the green is the full expansion pipe. So as you can see, even with a diffuser section, it's more effective than just a plain pipe, but the full pipe gives the best power.
Okay, I hope that's been of some use to some of you. It's helped me. Some of the reference material, design simulation, two-stroke engines. There's also a few SAE papers that I've had. These are Blair's work. They go into the right and leftward waves, the pressure wave, the superposition wave. There's even one on four strokes that also refers to it. Just a bit of reading to get back into it. So hopefully you'll all agree with me. These are, well clever. It's very, very clever. Very simple, but effective piece of equipment for increasing power. If anyone's got any points, any questions, please let me know. I'll try and answer them. Respond to you in the comments section as always. And if you like this today, please give us a like. Consider subscribing and give us a share. So next time I'll be continuing doing expansion pipes. So I'll continue with my pipe build and hopefully get the AR93 back on the dyno with a pipe.